Questions for Alex?
You gonna run another Wildcat this week, Alex?
No, hopefully not. One's enough for me.
Coach Bakuja said he got a little nervous when you took that run back inside instead of just going down. What were you thinking? Were you just trying to get yards?
Well, I was away from all the other guys, so it's kind of everyone kind of went over to the right side because that's the way we were supposed to, or we were going to kick the ball down the right hash with the rollout punt. So it just kind of opened up that way and then just went that way, I guess.
So you just read the end on that?
Yeah, well, the end's supposed to come up and pressure me to force the kick, and Blatchford held him up on the end, and they ended up going downfield, so I found the first down marker and just ran.
Were you surprised how long the run took? I mean, you were up that long.
Yeah, it kind of felt like, well, I kind of went everywhere, so it was, for 27 yards, I felt like I ran a mile and just... No, I don't recall the first half of it really, other than finding the first down marker. Once I got across the middle, I knew I had to wrap up the ball so I didn't turn it over. So just kind of, other than that, I just stayed away or ran to where space was open.
If you don't like contact, do you mind it at all?
It wasn't too bad. I don't think it's okay. It's.
Feel at all like a running back at all?
No.
No. They said they've always given you kind of the freedom to make that call on whether you're going to run it or not. At the point you made that decision, what was going through your mind at that point you made the decision to go?
Well, I don't know if they really gave me that freedom, but it just something I saw was open and I felt like I could get it, so just... I ran and took the chance. So
you just said, okay, it's open, I'm going.
Yeah.
Are you just like, I better hope I get this, otherwise Bo's going to...
Yeah, it could have been totally different if I didn't get it. It wouldn't have been very pleasant, I don't think.
What was the reaction from the coaches and your teammates when you got back to the sideline?
Well, they were pretty excited, and it just kind of, it kept our momentum going. I think it really, it got, obviously it led to the touchdown, so it just, it got our momentum going and helped the team out, and it was big, I think.
Did you see the Browns punter on Sunday? Do you think he got some tips from it?
I don't know. He kind of won up me. He doubled mine, I think. So his was pretty cool, I thought.
How about getting the field goal record now for the school as you kicked, I believe, three on Sunday?
Yeah, three.
And now you have the record for the school. How does that feel?
It's cool to be mentioned with guys like Chris Brown and them, just to be up there with them and just kind of, I mean, they're kicking on Sunday, so just something cool just to be up there with them. So.
What gave you more butterflies, running that punt or right before the kick against Colorado?
I don't know if I had butterflies for either, because it wasn't the punt, it was just kind of something I did on the run, so just... I guess Colorado, I had to think about that a little bit more. The punt was just kind of random.
Alex, your 52-yarder on Saturday, it looked like it had probably another 5-6 yards on it. How long have you made field goals in practice?
In practice, I've made up to 64 indoors. I forget, last year maybe, or a year before that, I'm not sure.
And outdoors?
I don't know if we really, during practice, we don't usually go back too far. I kick before the games, and me and Audie always just go back. I think I've hit 65 before a game once with a little wind.
Does that mean if needed and the coaches call on you for like a 64, 65 yarder, what would those emotions be like?
Well, I'd hope the wind was going in my favor. I don't know, just if we needed it, I would give it a go, I guess.
How far did you missed that field goal last year at Colorado, but how far do you think that ball went?
I hit that one real well. My kicks have a little right to left on it, and that one just stayed straight as an arrow. So, but I hit that one pretty well. I thought it was like a foot outside the post, I think.
Do you think that
that went about 70 yards.
5-7. Yeah, I'm not sure.
About 53, 54.
Yeah, I remember I hit it well. I don't, and it was probably one of my better hits, but it didn't go in.
Can you talk a little bit about the process? I mean, coming in here as a freshman, and now you're a record holder. Was there ever a moment that it just clicked for you? I mean, now you're automatic almost.
I don't know, just something that every day just work on. It's just, I don't know, it's like a golf game. I mean, you don't want to shank one, just kind of ruins your score, you know. So just something every day I work on, being consistent. If I miss one, I see what I did wrong, so fix it for next time, make sure I don't do that. So just something you try to be perfect on.
How do you do that? Do you look at the film of you kicking and then go through what you know to be technique, or do you have a reference for that?
I mean, I'll watch other kickers and see, what they do. But other than that, like, when I hit a ball, I know exactly what I did wrong because you can tell a lot by the spin of a ball. You'll see pro kickers, their balls end over end pretty much every time. If they get a little, right to left on it, you brought your toe up or you fell off. Or I know, so when I can see the ball, spin, I know, usually what I did wrong or right away, so... Just something you critique.
How key has Brett Maher been for you? Seems like he's good at that
point. Yeah, I've just since I've been here, I've had great holders with Wesh and Maher Cassidy. So just they're huge though. They lean the ball. They make sure it's fast enough, and just so their role is really important. Just so same with PJ Mangieri. He's done an excellent job this year. So.
Do you ever think about the NFL? I mean, has that ever crossed your mind? I know we're only halfway through the season.
Yeah, but still we have the whole season left. Just if I take care of my job, things will fall in place. It just, it's something you can't, let distract you from what you have going.
Coach Pelini mentioned that sometimes you don't always tell him what he wants to hear when he asks you if you can kick it. Has there ever been a time where you're like, I don't know if I can take it or anything like that?
I don't think so. I mean, I have my yard sets, and if he wants to go for one, during the game for the 52-yarder, he came up and asked me if I wanted to hit it, and I said yeah, and we hit it, and we went out and kicked it. So just, it's something I think it's huge. He has trust in me, and it just, he knows if he asks me that I'll give him an answer, and just, it's something I think it's huge between us, so. And during practice, he'll always say something like that. See, but if I miss one, he'll put a little draw on it, put a little fade on it. So he's funny about. But no, we have I don't communicate well. He trusts me, and I.
Do you determine that stat before each game based on wind, practice?
When we go out, we'll usually kick both ways and set our what you can make, and then you set. If you had to make one, how far could you go back? So usually you'll have two distance going each way. So just something we do before game. So.
Alex, you made 17 in a row outfield goals. It's pretty remarkable. How have you been able to do that?
I don't know. I didn't really know I had 17 in a row going until you guys had said it. So just something just with the consistency, just – going out there treating every kick like a new one. Even if I do miss one, the next one I come out, you got to clear your mind and just let it go. You have short memory, so.
Are you superstitious?
No.
So it doesn't bother you when people are always talking about your kicking? That doesn't affect your kicking?
No, I don't let it get to my mind.
If you're aware of the Missouri kicker, I don't think he's missed one this year. Do you know much about him?
He has missed one this year, I think. I think he's 13 or 14, but he didn't miss one last year. He did miss one last year, but he's doing really well again this year, and he hits a good ball, and he's a good kicker. So.
How many kickers do you watch?
A few. I don't know. Just I watch a few guys in the NFL, a few guys in college, just kind of see what they're doing.
I think a couple of years ago, you'd be in this position where you're at Nebraska and, potentially have a chance to play in the NFL. I mean,
talk us through where you're at right now and if you ever thought you'd get to this point.
No, I never thought I'd be in this point. Just something. I played soccer when I was young. I never dreamed of playing football or anything, even wanted to try it really till my soccer coach suggested I go out for it. So never really dreamed of anything being here or anything like that. So.
So the possibility of playing in the NFL wasn't a factor between Creighton soccer and Nebraska football?
No, just coming here to walk on, it was mainly just a shot. I didn't even know if I would ever play, so just something going here. I was going to go to engineering school, so just that was mainly the big factor.
When did you believe that you could possibly have a career doing this?
I always gave myself a chance. It was just something freshman year. My retro year, I didn't kick, but still I always gave myself a chance and worked to get better. That's just how I am.
You still follow Creighton soccer team?
Yeah, I'm going to try to watch their game tomorrow against Akron.
Number one team, they're playing the number one team.
Yeah, I know. They'll win.
Do you ever think about what you would have done if you went there, I guess? Do you ever
No, I don't really. I don't get into the what if I went there. I played soccer for my whole life. If I went there, I don't know. It would have been fun, but still I'm here and I love what I'm doing, so.